I think it's good that the government has decided finally to cut down on subsidy. It's something that's not sustainable. You cannot go on giving free lunches, you know, because you can't get something for nothing, you know. Undoubtedly, you must help the poor. You must help those who are handicapped. But you cannot continue helping them because the handicap, we hope, through our help, will no longer be handicapped. That should be the way. But you cannot continue to help handicaps to perpetually become handicapped, you know. So I welcome this this proposal or this decision to cut back on subsidy. But I think it must be done in a very gradual manner so that it will not burden the have-not and the poor, because it will come like a big thunderbolt, you know, on them. So I'm very mindful of that. And I think although the government has announced a very slight increase in prices of those essentials like sugar, diesel, oil, but what I'm concerned is, number one, the psychological effect it has on prices of products which are in need by the people, you know, like bread, like all those necessities, and prices will escalate, as has happened in the past. You think by increasing giving a slight increase in the price of sugar, it will not affect things that use sugar. But normally, the reactive is that because of psychology, prices of these things are put up. Prices of coffee, which has no relationship with the price of sugar, you know, goes up, you know, price of tea, price of all these things goes up and affects the poor. Is what about the subsidies given to all those organizations who will lumpy amounts in the form of subsidies? The IPP for power, you know, toll roads. The people are subsidizing them, and the government also subsidized them. Why you allow this to continue? And this runs into a lot of money, much more than what you save through the recent cut of 750 million ringgit. But the biggest problem is corruption. That is the biggest problem in the country. You see what the Merdeka survey has done. It indicated very clearly that the people at large are not happy with the state of affairs, especially the corruption that goes on, and there is much, much more than what you're trying to save through the savings by cutting on subsidy, which is only what, $350 million. It's a paltry sum actually compared to the amount that leaks out of the system, you know. The bugbear of the whole thing is the government satisfied in the fight against corruption? You know, the leakages is much, much more than what the government is saving. And then will the government cut on the expenditure, on unnecessary expenditure, which is considered waste, like going to tender on the government procurement? Can they do it in such a strict manner so that there's no waste, that public works and government procurement of goods and services are done in the best possible manner so that savings will be made, rather than savings in a manner that we have read in the papers this morning? I'd rather go after that, you know, rather than just adjusting the question of subsidies and saving 750 million. You may be able to save more than that. Is the government happy with the state of affairs now, insofar as corruption is concerned? But you read the Merdeka report. They say 70% of the people are not happy. And what are the government, what is the government doing about this? Now that's anybody's guess. Very difficult, you see. This is how people feel. It's how people feel. But if it's going to be a burden on the poor, I'm sure it's going to hurt Barisan National Parties. People are not going to say, you tax me more and I'll thank you for it. You tax me more, you burden me more, you look out. I'll hit you hard at the ballot box. Why doesn't the government look into this? Or they said they have to do it last night. Why last night? Why not last week, last month? Or why not next month? And come out with a good proposals that is palatable to the rakyat, you know, to the people.
Then they should discuss.
No, even if they don't want to discuss member of parliament, they have got any number of experts that they could rely upon, you know, for advice. Yeah, I don't know, rush or not, but why last night? Why can't they do it last week or last month or last year? Or why can't they wait next month, next week, next month? Timing is for the government to decide. But have they come up with something that they think will be acceptable to the people?
Parliament.
They don't want a debate, I suppose. Yeah. They want to avoid that. They don't want too many questions raised.
Very subtle.
Yeah. But it's not subtle. Now it's going to be debated in coffee shops and in offices and places like that, which is more damaging. It's better to have it debated in parliament than elsewhere, you know. I don't know why they choose this strategy, if it is a strategy. I don't know why. The economy depends on many factors, one of which is stability. Stability depends on security as well as on confidence that the public has on the government itself and on the leadership. And if FDIs do not come in as they used to, it's because they lack confidence. It's not because of anything else. Why do they go to Indonesia? Why do they go to Thailand? Last night I heard from some ambassadors, you know, whom I met over dinner, saying that he just came back from Bangkok and a lot of investments are going to Thailand. They've just postponed demonstration, you know, and money is going into Thailand in big quantities, according to these ambassadors. And a lot of money is flowing into Indonesia. Why has it not come here?
Not very far also.
Yeah. And why, I'm asking, money from here going out of the country? It's a lot of money going out of the country. Can we stop this money? Or can we provide incentives for this money to remain here if we can't get any money from foreign investments? Because the young needs jobs. And it's the government's responsibility to create employment for these people, you know, that's their bounden responsibility. Well, we hear of growth registering 10.1% for the first quarter this year, but there's growth compared to the first quarter of last year. But what about growth compared to the previous quarter? I'm not frustrated, I'm angry. I'm angry because the country can move ahead further than what it has done. I'm only angry. And we have a lot of money, it's all wasted away. And you hear of corruption, you know. And all the abuses, which really shame me, you know.